Senator Jenkins.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I also appreciate your comments. I know we're kind of focused on housing, I think, from the agenda in your comments. I want to make sure I understand. When we talk about housing, I see from like your 05 report, public accommodations, a complaint could be generated from any of the areas of disability, race, sex, national origin, blindness, age, ancestry, religion, or reprisal. So if you handle, if anybody has a complaint in any of those areas, and you describe that process, they could call you.
Absolutely.
I guess somewhat surprised that over 50% of the complaints that are filed deal with disability. I think the public probably would think the biggest number of complaints would be based on race, but I'm particularly close to Mount State Senator Remington living in my area and work with him. So this kind of opened my eyes that we've got a real problem. At least that seems to be a big area of concern. I don't see any, these are 05, 06. I don't see in the materials you presented any 08, 9, 10 numbers for housing broken down. I see lots of aggregate numbers of all complaints, but this was the only thing that showed the type of complaint. Do you have updated figures on the type of complaint and for the last couple of years broken down by disability, race, sex, et cetera?
We don't have it. I know exactly what you're, we did. It's kind of labor intensive. The system that we had, you had to do it manually. Quite frankly, when there was one of me, we were not going to get to that because people's cases needed to move. We didn't get it done because mainly the computer system we had doesn't accommodate that kind of a report. We mentioned T-Pots, which is tracks most of the housing cases, but we also have another system that tracks all of the cases that comes in the agency. It was developed along with the Federal Equal Employment Opportunity Commission, EEOC. Those cases in that database evolved, I guess, in a way in which the reports that we used to be able to generate when we had our own little system won't come out the same way. So we have to do it manually. We've not had the
This is a good opportunity, and I appreciate the
Senator Jenkins, I could interrupt a second. Who are you referring to in the reports about disability?
Here's what they've given us.
The chart?
One, they've given us the 09, 010, the 80.
I thought those were my handouts, sir.
Yeah,
I'm sorry, those are my handouts.
Oh, I'm just sir. Okay. We have the facts and figures to page 35. That shows recent years, which complements the Human Rights Commission report. But then there's a early dispute resolution program, and back in the back of it, under public accommodations for several years, 05, 06, they show the categories and the specific numbers under each, but the cover sheet is this one.
Thank you very much.
This is a good opportunity, and again, provided us with an excellent overview of the process, what you do day to day. Shift for just a moment. This is, you know, we want to be proactive. What specific recommendations from the Human Rights Commission or in the housing area would you say, please, here's what we need policy-wise. We need the statutory change, we need more resources, we need staffing issues, we need a tweak in Article 1. What is it that we can do proactively to address the issue of discrimination in West Virginia?
It's like hand in hand. Well, actually, I appreciate that opportunity to speak. My perspective is a little more housing oriented, so I don't go, you know, there was a time when I looked at the whole package of jobs, but right now my focus has been mostly on the housing. I would say what they've done in terms of given us an additional investigator or to help that, that effort. Because the investigator also, besides investigating, does education outreach work too, which is time. So staffing always is welcome if you can get additional staffing. From a policy or other standpoint, I'm not really in a position to say.
Senator, if I might, Mr. Moss, excuse me for interrupting, but next month, the director of the Human Rights Commission will be here, and she may be better suited to answer that question.
Absolutely.
I don't want to put you on the spot.
Yeah, I appreciate that. I wasn't going to step back. I mean, because I don't really know how, in fairness to her, she's just been made acting executive director. She is making some changes, trying some things, looking at the whole process. And it's too early for us to really know how things are going to work, but after a little while, she will be able to offer you some better guidance in terms of what she thinks should be done. Okay. But the statistics you mentioned, may reflect the addition of disability. When the numbers change, that ratio from mostly being race cases to a lot of disability cases, it's probably time to when the disability coverage came into our law.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Just a quick question. You mentioned education and outreach. I'm just curious, what has been done? I know I have a lot of constituents who do ask questions regarding complaints and issues that they've had before, and I've sent them to you all, but what is that process to reach the public?
Basically, we have an ongoing education outreach program. Our deputy director of American GK primarily is that person now. Prior to Ms. Lee retiring, she took that role, mostly going around and speaking wherever asked and talking about what the Human Rights Commission does in educating people. Now, we've divided that up among the rest of the staff. Mary Kay is the primary person. Josh and I get involved in that, and I'm sure our other housing investigator will be involved in the director of operations. So we kind of do it as a team, depending upon if there's an opportunity for us to do some clinical presentation or do some educating, set up a display case, hand out some things, talk to some people to better educate them in an area where we may be already going to investigate the case. We'll try to coordinate that. Oftentimes we'll partner with other agencies like the local Human Rights Commission, some of whom are not FAPS, but they're very active, and they refer cases up the road that actually come back down to us because they don't have that relationship. They may work on the case and can't go any further, and they'll send it up and they'll come back to us. So we maintain as good a relationship with all of those local agencies that we can and partner with them in different areas. There's also a Fair Housing Initiative program in Morgantown that we've partnered with some educational outreach efforts also. So we kind of do it that way, but we don't really have a real formalized program to say, but if someone calls and they need us to go somewhere and talk to some people, be present. For example, in Fayette County a couple weekends ago, because they were having their Solidarity Day this summer. I'm just about Fayette County, I forgot now. I think it was Solidarity Day. Unity Day or Solidarity Day, but it is an event where they have annually, and they come together with the community in that area, Fair Housing Counseling Agency from out in Fayette County, sponsored it, and asked us to come down and address it so we can pass out some information, ask the questions, and do a development on it. So a couple of hours on Saturday is no big deal, but we do that regularly if we need to do it. We just take our display board, grab some groceries, and we go on down there and do it.